Thank you, Brother Gene. Those words. As I was considering the word this morning and the word this evening, see, there's a time coming. I see that the mercy is that God's revealed this.
Yes.
God's told us about this.
Yes.
And not only has he just told us about it, what if God just told us about it? Well, that's all he did. He said, there's a day coming like this. And yet there was no remedy held out. Oh, what weeping and wailing. See, how would you live life knowing that this day was coming, but there was nothing you could do about it? It'd be a terrible thing. It's a day of darkness. But see, we've been given, actually, all those who have partaken of the grace of God have tasted that the Lord is gracious, and you know this day is coming. Well, what do? You warn every man. This is a time, it's a coming. Remember when Noah, now see, just the very fact that Noah was building an ark was a testimony. It was a testimony that he believed God, and a testimony that something was coming that wasn't like yesterday. Now you can imagine the boasting that flesh must have done in that time.
Yeah.
The mockings. The flesh hasn't changed any now. See, Satan, remember in our text, two times it goes over this. They said, I am. Now that's not a coincidence in the phrasing of the way that said. They're putting themselves in the place of God. They're saying, we are sufficient in and of ourselves. I am. Well, there is only one I am. Only one. Remember, he told Moses, he said, who should I say sent me? He said, say, I am has sent me unto thee. See, God is exactly who he is. He hasn't misrepresented himself at all. Now here's Noah. He's building this ark. Flesh, no doubts, boasted against it for 120 years. 120 years. But believe me, the moment it started raining, flesh lost all of its power to boast. Something's going on here. See, all of a sudden, they're crying for the rocks and the mountains to fall on them. But not one went into that ark other than what God had told Noah. Not one.
Right.
Now see, if you say that in the day we're living in, if you say God is exactly true to his word, and not one's going to get in except the ones that he's appointed. Oh, they'll label you as all kinds of different things. But the fact, it doesn't change anything. It hasn't changed anything. We know the terror of the Lord. That unless you're in the image of Christ Jesus, unless on that day you're found in him, complete in him, you're in a whole world of hurt.
Yeah,
there's utter destruction coming. You're going to be cast out of the presence of God. Oh, this is a terrible thing. A terrible thing to fall into the hands of a living God. They're destroyed. These ones that we've read about today and the ones coming, they're going to be destroyed for what they believed. They believed they could do it. They believed that they were sufficient, that they could handle whatever came their way.
Yeah.
But the fact is that because they believed that, they were destroyed. Because of that, because they said, I am able, God said, therefore.
Yeah.
See, and the time when they cry out, I won't hear them. I'll stop up my ears. The other place it says, I'll laugh at them in their derision. Now see, this is the God we serve. This is the same God that's merciful and just and holy. Why are we reading that these things are happening? Because, well, you cannot ignore God with impunity. You can't.
Amen.
He's spoken. Now, what's the exhortation? But God, who is rich in mercy. God's not willing that any should perish. He's not. See, he's long-suffering. He's patient. For his great love, wherewith he loved us. Even when we were dead in sin, he's quickened us together with Christ. By grace, you're saved.
Yes.
And I heard that all day today. Mm-hmm. All day today. It's been hammered over and over and over. And every warning and every exhortation to take hold, by grace, you're saved.
Yes.
And that not of yourself.
Yes.
See, it's not like you were good enough. Who would be saved if he only came to save the good ones? None. There's none righteous. No, not one. So see, now God is rich in mercy. He's rich in mercy. So see, it's not so innocent when a person ignores God. See, that's what God's demonstrating. It's not so innocent. See, Satan, he lifted up his own self in the presence of God now. And he was cast out of heaven, right? Now look at what we're seeing here. Why did these men do this? Because this is Satan working in them. This, he did exactly in them what he did in the presence of God. So now God's not going to save. We already know that God's not going to save Satan. He cast him out of his presence. What would God offer Satan? What could God possibly offer Satan that would change his mind? You see, he was right there in his presence. But now, see, now those that have, we have a whole chapter of Revelation on this in other places, but that if a person comes close to Christ and they've tasted the powers of the world to come, see, they're actually partaken of the divine nature. Now to go away from that, see, there's more involved. It's not innocent. So see, when we see God reacting like this, this is just and holy and righteous altogether. That's what his judgments are. In the end, if I watch one of my own sons cast into the lake of fire, I'll say, just and holy are you, King of Kings. Why? Because you'll see it for what it is. You'll see the truth as it is in Christ.
Right.
And you'll say, that's right. That was the right thing to do. Now, sometimes nowadays, you know, now is the time of salvation. Now is the day of making the declaration. That's the time. Now's the time for exhortation, isn't it? But you know, when the door was shut in the time of Noah's, that wasn't the time of exhortation anymore. There came a time when exhortation stopped, and all that was left was wrath. Now, in Noah's time, it was still mixed with a lot of grace, wasn't it? Noah found grace in the eyes of the Lord. But on that day, when we're lifted up above this planet, we're caught up together with him in the clouds. There's nothing good going to be going on the face of this earth. Nothing good. The elements are going to melt with a fervent heat. So we're living in a time when men have tried to fracture the message. And they've tried to segment. Say, just talk about the love of God. Just talk about, that's what we've been doing all day. Talking about the love of God. But see, it's bigger than just happy things. The very fact that believe me, when he takes away all defilement, and there's nothing that defiles at all there, we'll say, look what the love of God's done. Now, in order to do that, there's going to have to be, all evil's going to have to be cast out.
That's right.
Those that have identified themselves as being evil, they got to go. You see, that's all part of his love. That's all part of who he is. You can't abide in the presence of the Almighty and be contaminated. It can't happen. So in his mercy, he sent someone, he made a provision, made a way that God could, he could actually redeem those who he will. Whosoever he will. This is our God. Well, we can open this up for conversation now.